गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, वेलकम अगेन टू आवर प्रैक्टिकल सेशन ऑफ अ क्लाइंट साइड स्क्रिप्टिंग लैंग्वेज। टुडे इन दिस प्रैक्टिकल सेशन वील डिस्कस द एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर सेकेंड। इन प्रीवियस प्रैक्टिकल वी डिस्कस और विच सी द सिंपल जावास्क्रिप्ट प्रोग्राम विच डिस्प्ले हेलो मैसेज ऑन अ वेब पेज। ओके, नाउ इन दिस प्रैक्टिकल वी डिस्कस how to use decision making and looping statement in a JavaScript. This is our practical number second, that is develop a JavaScript to use of decision making and the looping statement. In our first chapter, that is basics of JavaScript programming, we learned the concept of decision making and looping statements. Here decision making in a JavaScript executes the statement only if the condition is true. And comparison operators are used while making the decisions. Okay, and the looping statement means loop in JavaScript are used to execute the same block of code a specified number of times or while a specified condition is true. Next point in our practical is practical skills. This practical is expect to develop the following skill. First is able to develop the JavaScript program using decision making, and second is able to develop JavaScript program using looping statement. And relevant outcome for this practical is create interactive web pages using program flow control. Next is the program outcomes. These are the relevant program outcomes, that is basic and discipline specific knowledge, problem analysis, design development of solutions, engineering tool experimentation and testing, engineering practices for society, sustainability and the environment, project management and lifelong learning. Next is practical outcome. In this practical, or practical outcome for this is develop a JavaScript to use of decision making and the looping statement. Relevant effective domain related to outcome is follow ethical practices, follow precautionary measures and the naming conventions. Next is minimum theoretical background. For this experiment or practical, we have to write the decision making statement. First is the if statement. If is used to check for a condition whether it's a true or false. Syntax for if is if condition and statement 1, statement 2. Next is a else statement. Else statement are used with the if statement. When if condition gets a fail, then the else statement will executed. Means if else statement, you can say that it is a if else statement. Here if condition is true, then the this block will execute. After that, suppose if the condition is false, then else part will be executed. Next is if statement. In this statement, there are various or varieties of conditions that you want to check. You can use multiple if statement to do this task. Suppose if condition 1 is true, then lines of code to be executed, means this statement will be executed if condition is true. Else if condition second is true, means else if condition is true, lines of code to be executed if condition 2 is true. After that, suppose condition 1, that is condition 1 and condition 2 is not true, means it is false, then else part will be executed. Next is a switch case statement or a switch statement. Switch statement do the same task that the else if statement do, but use of switch statement when the conditions are more. In that case, switch statement perform the better than the else if statement. Here you can use the expression and multiple cases, case value 1, 2, 3, 4 up to n, and a default statement. Suppose all the cases are false, at that time default statement will be executed. The switch case statement in a JavaScript is used for a decision making purpose, and the switch case statement is a multi-way branch statement. It provides an easy way to execution different parts of a code based on the value of a expression, based on the value of expression. Next is the while loop. Looping statement. This is the looping statement, while loop. Next is the for loop, for in loop, and the do while loop. This theoretical part is write down in your file. Next is additional resources required. Next part is the program code. Here program code. Develop a simple JavaScript with HTML for displaying the largest number between the two numbers. This is the first program, and exercise is develop a simple JavaScript to find the greatest number between the three numbers using if else if statement, and develop a JavaScript to demonstrate the use of switch case statement. Here I am performing a simple if else statement and a switch case statement. Likewise, you perform the program code and the exercise in your notebook. First of all, in a notepad file, write HTML, and here I am writing directly body tag. After that, here you can write a script tag. In a script tag, I am taking one variable name as a A, and here assigning the number as a 5. And here I am taking one condition, that is suppose a mod of 2 equal to 0, then the number become even. Here document.write means write method is used for this, and here a is a even number. Okay. That suppose a mod of 2 is not equal to 0, means in a else part you have to write document dot write a is or. Okay, after that close the script tag, close the body tag, and close the HTML tag. Save this file. With the HTML extension and see the output. What will be the output of this program? Here, value of a is equal to 5. Here I am initializing the value for that variable is 5. 5 mod of 2 equal to 0. Not, it is not 0, so that this condition is false, so that the else block will be executed, means a is a odd number. Let us see, this is the output of our program, that is a is odd. Okay, next program we have to perform in a if else if statement. First of all, HTML, next is the head tag, and here I am writing a title. In that title tag I am taking if else if as title, close the title tag. After that, here I am taking a body tag, and in a script tag I am taking one variable, that is var a is equal to, suppose I am taking the value of a is equal to 20. After that, I am taking one condition, it means in if block, I am taking a suppose equal to 10. Then this block will be executed. That is, here I am writing document.write a is equal to 10. Okay. Else if. Next condition. Else if suppose a equal to 15, then is equal to 15 will be executed, means document dot write is equal to 15. Okay, next point is the else if. Again I am writing the else if statement. Suppose in this block I am taking one condition, that is a equal to equal to 20, then this block will be executed, that is document dot write a equal to 20. Okay, after that I am taking the else condition. In this else statement or in this else block, suppose these three conditions are not true, means it is false, then else block will be executed. Here I am taking document dot write. In this statement I am writing a is not equal to, that is 10, 15 and 20. 10, 15, comma 20. Okay. After that, close this else, close the script, close the body tag and close the, close the HTML. Save this file. And see the output. In this program, first of all, I am assigning a is equal to 20. Here a equal to equal to 10. Suppose this condition is true, at that time this block will be executed. Suppose this condition is false, then it checks the second condition, else if. Suppose a is equal to equal to 15, then a is equal to 15 is displayed on a web page. Like this, else if, second else if block will be executed. Suppose these three conditions are not true, at that time else block will be executed. Let us see the output of this program. This is the output of our program. A is equal to 20. Means I am assigning the value to a is equal to 20 so that it display a equal to 20. Let us see simple example in switch case, using the switch case statement. In the notepad file, HTML, and I am writing a body tag. After that I am taking a script tag. In a script I am taking one variable, that is I is equal to 3, and here I am taking the switch case condition. Here I am taking one variable, that is I, and here case 0. Document dot write means case here, value of case is 0, then document dot write I is 0. Okay, suppose here use a break. After that, suppose case 1 means value is 1, then I am writing document dot write I is 1. Okay, after that use the break keyword. After that I am taking case second, that is case 2. Here also use the colon. Here I am writing document dot write I is 2. And use the break keyword. After that I using the default keyword. In that default, here document.write I is greater than 2. Okay. Close this switch statement. Close the script tag. Close the body tag. And close the HTML tag. First of all, in a switch case statement, value of I is equal to 3. It checks one by one all the conditions. First of all, case 0, suppose this condition is true, at that time this statement will be executed. After execution of this statement, the loops will break. Means here use the break keyword. After like this, case 1, 2, it checks. Suppose these three conditions are false, at that time it go to the default statement and execute this statement. Here value of I is equal to 3, so that the answer for this code is I is greater than 2. Let us see. First of all, save this file. And see the output. This is the output, I is greater than 2. This is the program code. This question and the, for the exercise and extra questions, if possible, try to perform or execute the program. Otherwise, only complete it in your notebook. Okay. Thank you.